Welcome back to TalkNorth.com. Thank you for listening. If you can, please download before you listen. It helps our business. I'd also like to thank our producer, Brandon Morton, and let you know if you'd like to sponsor this program or any of the programs on the network, you can reach me at jsouhan47@gmail.com. Remember in the bad old days when we all sat around saying, man, if the Timberwolves could just get one superstar, that would change everything. Right now, Karl-Anthony Towns is playing like a superstar. He's incredibly productive. He's incredibly active. He even has the personality you would want out of a young superstar. And the Timberwolves are just tripping over their own toes and look like they are not going to make the playoffs in a conference that ain't anywhere near as difficult as we thought it was going to be. Your thoughts, Jon Krasinski?
Yeah, I mean,
that was my TV. That was my local TV style interview. Your thoughts on basketball, Jon?
Very well. Yes. I like basketball. That's my main thought. But I would say you're right. In terms of waiting for that tentpole star, like that's been kind of the long time pursuit for this organization through Kevin Love, through Ricky Rubio, through all of the iterations in between, you know, the first go around with Kevin Garnett and now. I do think that Towns is becoming that before our eyes. He is playing better defense, even though the pick and roll defense against Atlanta was very much lacking. But he's playing better defense overall. He's reading things better. And then offensively, he's just something and someone that is very difficult to stop. And so that is always, I think, the hardest thing to find. But what we are seeing in this modern NBA is it takes more than one superstar. It's you need like not even Robin to Batman, you need a Superman and a Batman. And so the problem I think that the Wolves are running into so far is that Andrew Wiggins has regressed to the point of not even being Robin at this point. And, whether, Robert Covington comes back and is he that guy, that would seem a lot to ask of him. But they are still a ways away just in terms of getting Karl-Anthony Towns enough help around him to really be a factor. Now, you hit on the main point that one of the keys is that, the Lakers, Clippers, Spurs, Kings, like they all have flaws. And so the eight seed is there if you could put something together, and they had shown some signs of showing a pulse. But I guess what I kind of take away from this right now is they're not where they need to be, but maybe the rest of the Western Conference is not going to be as brutal for the long haul, and they can get back into this thing if they find the right people to make the right decisions to build the roster in the right way over these next couple of years.
I have a question along those lines. This is the Jon Krasinski Show, also known as the You Betcha Basketball Show, one of our basketball shows on TalkNorth.com. Also, we have the Cheryl Reeve Show. Appreciate everybody who listens and checks out all the other shows as well. Thanks to our producer, Brandon Morton. If you'd like to advertise with us, you can reach us at TalkNorthPodcast@gmail.com. Please download before you listen, and you can follow us on Twitter, TalkNorthPod on Twitter. Thanks to our sponsors, TSR Injury Law, TSR 612 TSR Time, and SodaStick, SodaStick.com. Our deal with SodaStick is you can use the promo code YouBetcha to get free shipping on any size purchase, and we'll tell you about a special deal they have coming up here shortly. So my tendency when I watch this team, when I try to give them the benefit of the doubt, is to say, maybe Robert Covington is the second most important player on this team and missing him really is devastating. Am I overreacting to what I'm seeing on the court when I think that way?
No, I mean, look, they really do miss Robert Covington, no doubt, and it sounds like he's going to be back in a matter of days. He has begun a rehab assignment with Iowa, and it won't be very long. I would imagine he'll get some contact work in practice. He'll kind of just get up and down the court a little bit, and it probably, you know, by next week at the very latest, I would think he's going to be up here playing. And they miss him in so many ways. They miss his defensive versatility. They missed his three-point shooting. He just does a lot of the things well that they're not doing well right now. Now, I think that what has become clear over these last few weeks with him out is that he's their second best player, and that's not a good situation either.
Right.
You want it to be ideally Towns, Wiggins, clear number two, Rocco number three, maybe Sarge number four, and go from there. And then you have the makings of a pretty solid team. But as long as Covington is your second best player, that it brings limitations to what you're able to do. But, you know, you look at some of the teams that are causing them problems, like ideally against Atlanta on Wednesday night when Trae Young was slicing and dicing them. Maybe they put Covington on Young, and maybe his length and his instincts bother that rookie in the pick and roll a little bit more. You know, they can switch him on to threes and fours if they need to. He is mobile. He is communicative. And just so many times what we have seen also on the offensive end is Towns gets a lot of attention on the block. He kind of kicks out into a corner and Okogie misses a three, or Wiggins misses a three. Saric even misses a three sometimes. And if Covington can come in and shoot 38%, 40% from three, man, that just changes the calculus a lot on what can be done and the damage that you can do. So there's no question that they have missed him a lot. That said, they should have beaten Atlanta without him. They should have won a few other games at New Orleans without him, at Memphis without him. Like there are other things that should be happening for this team. They should be able to weather that storm.
We're recording this on Thursday morning, so by the time you hear this, you may or may not have watched the Wolves on Thursday night, and if something happens Thursday night, it may not be included in this podcast. We'll get to it next week. We're kind of going more big picture today. Glenn Taylor said something. Well, Glenn Taylor spoke with Sid Hartman, and if we want to take Sid at his word, what would you take from that conversation?
Well, one of the things that he said to Sid that is getting a lot of attention is that he thinks that Ryan's done a pretty good job so far, and that he likes the relationships that are being built with the players. He likes what he sees from a chemistry aspect, from using more of his bench than Tibbs did. And that has led some people to assume that the decision's already been made, that it's going to be Ryan's job. I can tell you the decision hasn't been made. That said, I do think that Ryan is in the driver's seat. I think that if he earns it down the stretch here, it will be his job. But there's still a long ways to go between now and then. And you look at the type of loss against Atlanta. That was the type of loss that Glenn cited when firing Tom Thibodeau as well, like that, you know, losing to at home to Atlanta, on the road to Phoenix, like those kinds of bad losses. So there's going to be 20-some games left. If the team falls off a cliff and does not play well against a very tough schedule, I think it's entirely possible that Glenn looks for someone else. But I do also think that with all of the injuries, with all of the adversity that this team has faced under Ryan's watch, I think he's done a pretty good job. They're 10-11 in his 21 games, and he clearly does have the respect of the players in the locker room, which is a good start. He is doing a good job communicating with them and getting them on the same page. And what they need, what they really, really need, is for Covington to get back, and so then they can kind of look at what a team looks like that's close to fully healthy with Ryan coaching. Then you can kind of look a little bit more at his X's and O's, at his schemes, at his rotations, at what he does and see if that's the guy for to lead this team going forward. And we'll see on that. But you know, there's no reason to jump to a conclusion yet because there's been no conclusions jumped to. This process is going to play out over the final 5 or 6 weeks of this season, and a lot can happen for the good for Ryan to lock this thing down. A lot could happen for the bad for them to look for something else.
Man, so many things to get to. I think what we have learned is that Andrew Wiggins is Andrew Wiggins no matter who he plays for. Let's get into that a little bit here. We also have some good Twitter questions we're going to get to. Do want to thank TSR Injury Law 612 TSR Time. We've told you about Steve Terry. You've heard Steve Terry on the show. He's actually a really good guest or co-host. He has some insights about the Wolves from seeing things behind the scenes. He's also not afraid to tell you what he thinks. And, you know, you're going to get that kind of upfront, straight ahead representation and advice if you ever need their particular kind of help. 612 TSR Time is what you call. If you need an injury lawyer, you can also go to TSRinjurylaw.com and check out their website. You'll find out just how well regarded their key lawyers are, how many awards they win. You can see the actual cases they win, the settlements they win, and the key, you know, a couple of key things that Steve has reminded me, and we should remind you. If you need this kind of help, you want the help from the beginning. They're not going to charge you anything unless they win the case. So call them right away. Get their help right away. Don't get buried beneath bureaucracy. Don't say the wrong thing because you didn't have representation. Get a hold of them right away. And, you know, the other thing is they make it easy. They'll come to you. They'll give you a free consultation. There's just no downside to contacting them if you're ever in a position where you need their kind of help. So 612 TSR Time or go to TSRinjurylaw.com and email them for a free consultation. And of course, you know Steve's face. You see it everywhere, including on Timberwolves broadcasts. You see him sitting courtside. But you know, we've gotten to know Steve, and we've gotten to know the key players at TSR, and they've been great to us. We trust them. You know, if I ever needed an injury lawyer, I would call them, and not just because I have 612 TSR Time memorized. So 612 TSR Time. TSRinjurylaw.com, and go to the website and check out all the cool stuff. I guess cool stuff isn't the right phrase. All the important stuff about them, all the ways they can help you if you need their help. So, you know, Wiggins, just another one of those blah games on Wednesday night. It wasn't one of his worst games. He wasn't completely invisible, but, you know, he felt like he was just kind of coasting through the game, and his defense, it just felt like he was a half step slow in reacting to any time they really need him to make a stop.
Yeah, I mean, look, I think through three and a half quarters, he played pretty well. He was knocking down shots. He was defending, and he was doing good things. Then you get to overtime, and he's outplayed by DeAndre Bembry for the whole period. He has an airballed three. He, you know, just, I think he went 0 for 3 with nothing across the board, no rebounds, nothing. I'm kind of grappling with this because I think I can sense a little bit of the Joe Mauer effect coming to Andrew Wiggins here, where, like, because he's making a lot of money and because he's not starring, he is all of a sudden the root of all ills, and every single problem starts and ends with Andrew Wiggins. And that's not the case. There are games that he plays well, and there are things that he does well. But the simple fact of the matter is that he has not been an elite player near often enough this season. And so, like in those situations against Atlanta, they give up a lead down the stretch. They are fighting and scratching and clawing to stay in the playoff race. They go into overtime. Your max player can't get outplayed by DeAndre Bembry. Like, it just can't. Like, it can't happen when nothing else is going right for your team either. So, I think that is the responsibility that you take on with a deal like that. And for too often this season, Andrew Wiggins hasn't even been close to an elite player. And there's been a couple games where he has been, and then there's been other games where he's been good. But the Wolves as currently constructed, need him to be elite far more often than he is, and that is causing some major issues for what this team is trying to do.
And if you just look at statistics, which I never feel like is the final